Namaste, I am Ajit and you are watching Op India. This whole video is intended for white Christian folks or maybe Europeans and American who are pretty oblivious of the fact that Delhi riots are anti-Hindu riots. Hindus are majority in this country called India. So let me start with what are these riots and how it has been reported in English media. These riots were in a way conclusion to what was being pushed for quite a long time in this country in the garb of NTCAA, NRC, NPR and several other abbreviations that you might have come across. CAA is Citizenship Amendment Act, which has been amended by Modi government, which by the leftists, liberals, Islamic terrorists, terrorist apologists and the likes is often being called as Nazi regime, fascist, as well as they go on to call him Hitler as well. Citizenship Amendment Act was intended to give citizenship or make it easier for six of the minorities of neighboring countries, Afghanistan, Pakistan and Bangladesh, who share borders with India, where Hindus, Parsis, Jains, Bauds, Christians and one more community is persecuted on the basis of religion. They are in very, very, very shitty conditions. You can go and read about them, their condition, how their population has been on a continuous decline in these nations. Their religious structures are demolished. They are always framed in the garb of blasphemy laws. They are murdered, brutalized, their women are raped. These are very much a regular phenomenon in these nations. So India, a natural home for Hindus, if you may call it, tried to bring these minorities, and these all three countries are Muslim majority by, I mean to say 95% or even more than that, Muslims are there in these countries. So Indian Muslims and the leftists, who have always been trying to get media attention or international attention on India, since the time Modi took as Prime Minister in this country, they tried to demonize him and tried to project him as someone who is demonizing Muslims or who is against Muslims. Here they tried to tell the folks that your citizenship will be taken away, whereas there is no provision of taking away someone's citizenship. It is for giving away or easing up the rules of citizenship for certain minorities who have been continuously brutalized, murdered, killed, raped, or any shitty thing you can imagine that is happening in these nations. Of course, Amnesty International and UN Human Rights will never report them as regularly as they should. They just do it once in a while, but still you won't be able to find it. You will be able to find it in local media reports and you should go and search for them. So this was building up. This started as a movement in India, NTCAA protests. And while protesting in several provinces or states in India, there were arson, riots, murders, locally made guns that were used to shoot people. 30 people alone died in these violence in Uttar Pradesh, one of the largest provinces of India with one of the largest population of Muslims. And these riots were majorly dominated by Muslim folks and in those particular areas. And this started to spread out. It came to Delhi. There is one particular place, Shaheen Bagh, that is properly covered in international media by, and also in domestic media here, particularly in English ones. Shaheen Bagh. Shaheen Bagh has a few hundred women from Muslim community who have blocked one major highway that connects UP and Delhi. which is affecting lakhs of people. Millions of people are being affected. They are unable to reach to hospitals. They are unable to reach to schools. They are unable to reach to their working places. People are losing jobs. People are dying because they cannot reach the hospitals in time. And these stories are never brought about in international media or even in English media or leftist tilted media in India. So this continued and it resulted in a violence that has been happening in East Delhi, the capital of India. And before Shaheen Bagh, there was a large scale violence in Jamia Nagar, where this area is situated and where one university is situated. In that particular university, some radicals from Islamist group called PFI, 150 of them, they were living among locals. They set fire. They set fire to buses which has CNG cylinders in them. Had they caught fire, it would have taken few blocks, you know, around them. This happened. They started stone pelting, one of the favorite things to do for rioting Muslim mobs in India. They did that and they took refuge in Jamia Millia University. In the library, they were chased by cops and they were asked to surrender. They were even handled as per the protocols of policing. Now these things were made into some reason so that they can continue to demonize police forces that they attacked students. Nobody is trying to tell the story what happened prior to police entering the university. These students were pelting stones. They have been seen pelting stones from inside the university onto the police. They set fire to vehicles, private vehicles as well as government property. Similar violence were reported in West Bengal, one of the provinces where Muslims are in good number. In Muslim majority area like Bashirhat and other places, 250 crores worth of property were tossed in just 2 days by mobs coming out of mosques, masjids and going on a rampage. These were the things which were never reported by majority of international media or even domestic media in English. Now the whole thing reached to a point where several places the roads were being blocked in the name of solidarity with Shaheen Bagh. They are asking the government to relent on the law that has been passed by the parliament, both the houses of parliament, which is not going to happen. Now their logic is, in a democracy the voices must be heard. Okay, they are challenging the basic principles of democracy and representation, where 303 parliamentarians have been elected by a majority of this country and they are in power. So they bring about a law granting citizenship or easing the way of getting citizenship for persecuted minorities in three countries that I named earlier. Now these guys, they are saying, we are in 1,000, these members of parliaments are just 303. So we are in larger numbers, so their voices should be heard, and that's why they are going to block the whole, you know, roads and places, public places and all. This started happening all around the northern side of India and some parts of the world in solidarity with these women who are sitting. Protest is a right in India, it is a fundamental right, but at the same time, the fundamental rights, if they encroach upon others' fundamental rights, your fundamental rights end. That doesn't have to happen, but this is happening very much in India. Now they were trying to cut off 4 major roads of east side of Delhi, East Delhi that is. In those areas, several people tried to block a road. Then there was this BJP leader who is being demonized on Wikipedia. Again, another thing I must say, they have heavily edited out the facts on these riots on Wikipedia page and made it solely anti-Muslim riots. But the stories that I am going to narrate here tell a completely different story. One of the editors or moderators was removed by Wikipedia for doing so. He has had a history of being left-leaning and anti-right, and anti-fact for that matter, if you will. So Kapil Mishra, this BJP leader, he said in presence of a police personnel that if you guys do not vacate the roads, we will also take to streets and we will help you vacate the roads. And now that has somehow become one of the reasons that Islamists and rioters are telling people that because he said so, that's why this violence erupted. And now what ensued after that? So we have this Shah Rukh guy who is a Muslim, and he was shooting from his gun. 8 times he shots fired in the air, and even as cops approached him, he kept on firing his gun. What is the leftist media and English media in India writing about him? At first they wrote that he was a Hindu guy, just because people around him had saffron colored baskets. They failed to realize that people now have mobile phones which can record videos, and media hegemony of throwing away one kind of narrative to people, this has been stopped for a while now. So people have shot these videos, and you can see some of them has skull caps, traditionally belonging to Muslims. And later on, when he was identified, he was named as a Muslim guy. His mother is indulged in drug trafficking. His father is a drugs distributor. One of his uncles is in jail for the same. So he belongs to that kind of a family. Whole mob was a Muslim mob. Now what happened? People retaliated and violence ensued. Later on, it became a full-fledged riot in several adjoining areas where Muslims were in majority. And this was properly planned, which I am going to talk about in a while. The whole English media tried to whitewash the crimes of Muslims, even as gory details started to emerge that people were stabbed 400 times. I will talk about that in detail as well. People were, their limbs chopped off and thrown in fire. They were dragged because their bike had Jai Shri Ram, a Hindu chant or mantra or whatever you try to call it, that was written on his bike, a symbol. He was dragged by 40 odd men, killed and returned to his lane. This whole thing was whitewashed, this whole jihadi thing was whitewashed by a section of media, and they tried to pin this down by showing some of the selective pictures, like one of the pictures you might have seen by Reuters news agency, where one Muslim guy is surrounded by several Hindu or non-Muslim men who are trying to beat him, and he has this blood and all. So you see or watch this image and get emotional about it, what is minority being subjected to, but you don't know what happened before that. This guy was going to torch his shop. This guy was indulging in arson. He was going to steal or do something to that shop, and he was caught and he was thrashed by people. So just this particular photograph doesn't tell the whole story. Similarly, you will find likes of Barkha Dutt, who writes for Washington Post, Rana Ayub, and several, Rajdeep, Ravish Kumar, the stalwarts of journalism who are very much respected in Western circles. They are all whitewashing these crimes, and they will bring about a story of some Imran, a Muslim guy who is a rickshaw puller. They will bring out this story and they will tell that how he was slapped by a mob. And again you will start to think, oh, why was he slapped? He was just going around doing his business. Now I will talk about some brutalities that has come to light. One of the IB guys, that is a government agency, named Ankit, he was a Hindu. He was snatched away by 4 of Tahir Hussain's, a Muslim guy, one of the corporators of that area, elected representative from the party that is ruling Delhi, Aam Aadmi Party. He was snatched away by four guys and his body was so much brutalized. Just think about this. I am trying to tell you what forensic doctors or autopsy report says. He was stabbed 400 times. Six people took turns to stab him and this whole act of stabbing continued for 2 to 4 hours. His eyes were gouged out. His intestine was taken, ripped apart from his stomach. This is how they killed him and then they threw him in one of the drains, sewage drains, from where his body was recovered. And when this brutality came to light, the drains of that area were started to, they were being, you know, search parties were sent, and as many as 10 bodies have been recovered as yet, and we are trying to bring out all the autopsies and who were those people who died in that. Another story is of one 19-20 year old guy from Uttarakhand, a small province of India. He was working in a sweet shop. His limbs were chopped off, all four, hands and legs. And if you can see his photograph, only his head and this torso. That part is, you know, among the white ash, it is visible, only that much of it. If people were dying in riots, you might say that people are dying in riots, this is, you know, a general thing. No. People die in riots, they might get hit by a, say, stone, or somebody comes with a gun and, you know, shoots him in the face or somewhere. There have been several such stories as well. But when you take time to, you know, chop out limbs, throw him in fire, 40 people drag someone because he has certain sentence written on his bike, 400 stabbings on one person. This tells you the story of this ISIS style execution that Muslims do in Syria and such places. So if you try to, you know, steer away from that, then you will always like the story of Imran who was slapped by some Hindus. Leftist media of India, likes of The Wire, Scroll, Print, Quint, these are continuously trying to whitewash the crimes of a community just because they happen to be Muslims. They are trying to show you, or the world media, or the people, the Christian folks or white skinned folks in USA and Europe and Canada and all these nations, that a slap on the face of Imran, a Muslim guy, is heavier and it weighs more than 400 stabbings on the body of a Hindu guy because he belongs to, say, majority. Another story is of Vinod, who I told you, he was dragged by 40 Muslim men, killed, murdered, butchered and then thrown into his own lane. Then there was this Alok Tiwari, who has two young kids. He had gone to fetch some milk for his kids and he was shot dead. Another is a Dalit guy, Dinesh Kumar. He was going, you know, outside and he was shot and killed. Another one is Rahul Thakur, another is Rahul Solanki. These are all Hindu men. We tried to talk to the women of that area and this happened without any, you know, we were just going in that area to do some ground reporting, and these women from that particular area tried to tell us their stories. When they realized that we were journalists, they told us that 10-year-old, 11-year-old, 12-year-old girls were passing from the lanes of Muslim majority areas. Their clothes were snatched and they were sent home naked by Muslim men. Muslim men would stand on their roofs naked, stark naked, wave their penis and ask them, come over, come to me. This is the situation in those areas. Just imagine this happening to a white skinned folk who is not able to believe my words. Just imagine these kind of stories, that your son is out and he is stabbed 400 times, his intestines, you know, taken out, ripped apart. Then there is a tale of two schools. There are two schools. One is owned by Hindu. That school was pretty much famous in that area, and it was doing a good job of educating kids, and it has an intake of all kinds of students, Muslims, Hindus and other communities of that area. And there was this another school, Rajdhani School, owned by a Muslim guy. This school was, it has a tall structure, it is one of the highest buildings in that area. It belongs to one Farooq Faisal, a Muslim guy. When we visited the roof of that school and visited the school as such, the whole destruction was completely done on purpose, just to show that something has happened here as well. A few tables turned around, tumbled around. One of the sofa was set on fire, just that much, and 3-4 glass panes were shattered. That much of damage was done to a Muslim school. The Hindu school, the Hindu guys' school, it shares the boundary wall, they are in same locality. It was burned to ashes. Not a single classroom was left. It was set on fire. The projectors were either taken away, looted, or they were, you know, just burnt. You will see images and you will realize how much of destruction has happened in that particular area. Then when we went onto the top of that particular school belonging to the Muslim guy, we saw improvised slingshots. We saw petrol bombs. Petrol bomb is a thing that you put pour petrol inside a bottle, and then you have some cloth inside that bottle. You set fire and you throw it away. Slingshots were used to throw it farther away, in targeting Hindu areas. That particular school was used as a base to target Hindu homes, Hindu temples, Hindu schools and people. Several eyewitness testimony says that people were firing from that school. And the media like Wire, NDTV, which you folks rely more on, they reported that both the schools belong to Muslims and they were gutted. Think about the sheer shamelessness of these left-leaning or leftist media, that when a Hindu guy's school is burned down to ashes, it is being projected, the visuals are being shared and projected as Hindu mob set a fire to Muslim on school. You will read it, you will see the images, and you will say, oh, Hindus are running amok and they are setting fire to Muslim institutions, and they are, you know, trying to target minority community. This is what is being fed to you. How was this whole thing planned? You will say that riots are organic. It happens. Somebody said something, someone retaliated, and people took to streets and started pelting stones. No. Initial reports are saying that 7 trucks, big trucks, truckload of bricks and stones were brought in that particular area on the pretext that several people from those communities, they brought it to mend their houses. It was for construction purposes. The amount of rock as well as bricks, it was enough to build a 5-story structure in that particular area. Half of that pile is gone. It is spread out on roofs of Hindus and even on Muslims, and streets, roads, lanes and bylanes. You will find matchboxes in hundreds, not just single or, you know, 1-2, hundreds spread around in that area. People were using that to light up the fire of petrol bombs so that they can, you know, set fire to temples and Hindu homes and Hindu houses and Hindu shops. Hundreds of liters of petrol were ferried, you know, you go to petrol pump, have your gas tank as you guys say, or petrol pump tank, petrol tanks filled with that, and bring it to homes, empty it into bottles and store it on your roofs. Muslim guys' roofs were used for that. Ganga Jal. Ganga Jal is water from river Ganga, which is very, very, very sacred to Hindus. We consider her as mother, Mother Ganga. Acid factories owned by Muslims used this branding, Ganga Jal, for acid. Acid bottles were collected, stored on roofs of Muslim guys, and ladies were throwing, Muslim women were throwing acid on security forces as well as Hindu mobs, which was, you know, panicking, running from everywhere to everywhere. Just think about it. It rained acid on Hindus. Think about the brutality and meticulous planning of this whole riots. Women and children were incited by their own husbands and brothers to come on street, fire guns, hurl stones, throw acid bottles and petrol bombs on their own people, who till yesterday they had this, you know, hi hello kind of thing, that kind of relation, oh we are friends and all. Women and kids were used for this. They were prepared. Slingshots were made, movable slingshots on thelas, hand carts, so that you can go into lanes and you can launch it onto every single floor of Hindu houses, so that it is not that just one floor of Hindu building has caught fire. No, their target was to just annihilate anything and everything that is Hindu. Every 10 to 15 house in that locality has this improvised slingshot, stored stones in big baskets or canisters and cartons and other things. Every single 10-15 roofs we have gone and we have seen this. Even the mosque in that locality has stones on their roof. Just tell me, what is the use of stones on the roof of a mosque? Kids, Muslim kids, were taken away from that particular Hindu school that I just talked about. Their parents came and they said, we want to take away our kids. They took their kids anticipating violence. Whole community was hand in gloves with each other in this violence against Hindus. There were two houses which were major bases for this. There is one Tahir Hussain that I talked about, and there is this school guy, Farooq Faisal, whose whole school roof was used as a base. And then there were smaller houses, every 10 to 15 houses of Muslims that was used for that. So that not a single Hindu house or temples or even shops, nothing is left standing. Everything has to be burned down to ashes. Now talking about destruction, that was the meticulous planning that I am talking about. Muslims planned it for 2 to 3 months in advance. It was not an organic riot. No, it was properly planned. People from Rajdhani school, that Muslim school, climbed down from ropes into the Hindu school to burn that particular school. We have visuals for that. Just think about it. No one learns in India. US guys or European guys, you might be, you know, taught rock climbing and climbing the ropes up and down, but not in here. But just see, they might have been training themselves for this rope climbing and all. They descended from that four or five story tall building, and then they wreaked havoc on that particular school that belonged to Hindus. This is how much detailed they were in their plans. The roads that they blocked, that all was chosen for a particular purpose, so that the whole communication in that area is disrupted. Nobody can go out, nobody can come from outside. They took away Hindu shops, only Hindu shops. So there are, say, 10 shops in one row, only the shops that belong to Muslims that was left untouched. Nothing happened to them. Then there were Hindu shops which has Hindu names like Mahalakshmi, Arora Furnitures. These are Hindu or Punjabi names or Sikh names. They were looted and then gutted. First you loot out the property, whatever you can take away, then set it on fire. Muslim shop is standing polished and as good as new, or however nice it looks when they open it in morning. That speaks how this whole violence was planned by one community against the other, that is Hindus of that particular area. One marriage party of a Hindu was targeted. Why? Because when there is a marriage party in India, caterers come with cylinders, liquefied petroleum gas, LPG, cooking gas cylinders. Just imagine how nicely they had thought about it. If you set fire to those areas, if cylinder, you know, blasts, it will take away the whole block in locality. 7-8 cylinders and whole area is done. Your house is, note that, you know, your house is so nicely built, this Tahir Hussain's house which was targeting that marriage house. It is very heavily, nicely built house without any windows on three sides of it. It is a large house. It housed 3,000 people on that particular day, locals say. At one time on the roof, for which we have videos, there were more than 500-600 people on that roof. And just think about it, the amount of stones and acid and petrol bombs they might have stored, that the carnage kept on going for hours and hours and hours. Nobody knows what was going on in that Muslim guy's house, who is an elected representative from that particular area. Nobody knows. Have you heard about it? No. He is being painted as someone who did this all. Did this all, 3,000 people entering his house, having so much of stones on his roof, petrol bombs and acids and slingshots and whatnot. Oh, he did it in, you know, self-protection. He was protecting himself. If somebody attacks him, what will he do? So he had 3,000 people protecting him from God knows what. This is the shitty logic that is being written about in English media and international media, so that a jihadi, a fasadi, because he is a Muslim, he is shielded and nobody touches him. One petrol pump was set on fire. Just imagine it. They didn't, you know, choose to set fire something else, but a whole petrol pump, just think about it, had its tanks that is underground, had that, you know, caught fire, what would have happened? Just think about it. What would have happened to that whole locality, which has majorly Hindu population? They knew what they have to target. They set fire to buses with CNG cylinders, which uses gas. They targeted a marriage party, which has gas cylinders. They targeted petrol pumps. This is the level of meticulous planning of writers, and you are being told that, oh, it was all organic and Hindus attacked Muslims. Now the thing is it Islamophobia that I am reporting these facts to you? I brought about these stories to you. We have covered tens of stories from the ground. We have been into those areas. Our reporters, Op India reporters, have visited those places, visited the victims. A 19-year-old guy has drill, you know, holed into his skull. He is in ICU. One of the cops was killed by a bullet. Another IB guy, I told you, 400 stab wounds, intestines, you know, torn apart, eyes gouged out. Several Hindu men and women died. we are awaiting confirmation on the names. Many are yet to be discovered from drains. Many are missing. Nobody is telling you these stories because you are being shown photographs of one Muslim, you know, kid in this skull cap with a sad look on his face because someone has been beaten around in the house. This is what you are being shown. Very innocent faces, very emotional stories which turn out to be fake. Whatever this shitty media houses are telling you, these are all fake stories just to save or whitewash the crimes of Muslims. Muslim mob, if it indulges in arson, riots, stone pelting, throwing petrol bombs, killing and murdering and butchering people, how is that it is Islamophobia? Because I choose to report it. Can you dispute this fact? Or will you just keep on telling me that no, why are you telling that Muslims are, you are choosing just to report the crimes of Muslims? Are these crimes fake? Are these lies that I have manufactured? No. If these are, file a case against me. If these are lies that we have reported, then call out our lies. You have fact-checking people working round the clock to denounce us and catch our lies. Why they aren't able to do that? Because we are reporting the truth. We have gone on to ground. We have met people whose loved ones were snatched away. There was this young kid who was one of the four people who were dragged by Tahir Hussain's goons, slaughtered, butchered and thrown away. And he was so sad and he is still in shock that he couldn't do anything. Till the time he could turn away and look what happened to other three guys that were snatched with him, they were gone. They were gone into Tahir Hussain's house, a Muslim guy. These kinds of stories are never told to you because, well, somebody has to play secular, you know. How can we report about them? If one community's people or murderers, rioters, have been wreaking havoc on another community which happens to be a majority, we should not report it. This is the line of leftist leaning and leftist liberal media in India and around the world maybe. This is not Islamophobia. Islamophobia will be the fact that when we report something that has not happened. So there is this Hindu phobia that NDTV is suffering, or Wire is suffering, The Wire, a US citizens owned portal, thewire.in. Those guys are manufacturing a lie to demonize Hindus when Hindus' school is set on fire by Muslim mob, and they are reversing the whole thing, calling that school belongs to Muslim and Hindu mob set it on fire. This is how it is being reported and this is how it is reaching to you guys. That's why I had to come and make this video in English, because I have been making videos in Hindi. Just imagine this on yourself happening to you in your locality, to Christian white folks. What will you do if your, you know, grade 6 or 7th or 8th daughter is going to school and some people are flashing their penis? They are asking her to come to him. They are snatching away her clothes and sending them back to you naked. Think about it. Think about the fact that your son is, say, working in McDonald's or somewhere. He is trying to earn some money and make ends meet or help out the family. He is dragged by a Muslim mob. Your son's hands and legs are chopped. They set fire to that McDonald's and throw it in that fire. And you are left with a shape of a head, a torso. That's it. it is of same color as the ash of the McDonald's furniture. Think about it. Think about it that you had a cross in your say around your neck or on your vehicle. 40 people come from somewhere and they see that here is a cross. They drag you out, beat you to the pulp, hit you, stab you, kill you, burn you alive, throw your body in front of your house. How will you feel about it? These all things happen to Hindus in India's capital city, that is New Delhi. What you are being shown? Oh, that Muslim Imran was slapped by a Hindu mob. Oh, that guy was being beaten away by Hindu guys. They are writing this gun wielding Shah Rukh. He was a PUBG lover. He used to make videos on TikTok. He wanted to become a model. This is the line they take when a terrorist gets caught by security forces. They will try to humanize him. You know that Osama bin Laden was called a lovable father by one of the media houses in India, the Quint. How would you react to the fact someone from say CNN, or CNN in fact can do that, say Fox News says that Abu al-Baghdadi, the ISIS guy, he was a headmaster's son. Or they, you know, try to tell you he loved baseball and he was very pro-US. These are the kinds of stories that are being written about terrorists in India by the media houses that you are reading to know about riots in India. Wikipedia pages are vandalized, edited, re-edited, re-edited just to suit one side's propaganda. This is what is reaching to you. We need to break this whole idiotic stigma of reporting the crimes of Muslims as something untouchable. No, if a Muslim is a criminal, we need to pronounce his name. We need to put that in headline. Not because he's a Muslim, no, because he's a criminal, because he's a writer, because he's an arsonist, because he might have raped somebody. That's why you have to put his name and religion, because religion is the motive here. There is a concept of love jihad in India, where this Muslim young man lure other communities' girls, Christians included, into falling in love with them. So far so good, you know, two souls are loving each other. But the religion or love jihad comes into practice when that beloved of your girl rapes you, gets his father to rape you, gets his friends to rape you, then he murders you and dumps you somewhere. This is what is happening in India. And these are not one singular instances. No. There are several instances. There are men who are after Hindu, Christian, Sikh, other women. They talk to them. They take them to some secluded area, or they even marry them after converting them into Islam. And then they rape them, ask their brothers to join him, friends to join him, father-in-law, and who knows. And then they kill her if she, you know, doesn't participate. This is what is happening in India. That is how grave the threat of one particular community is here. So there are people who have vested interest, who doesn't like an elected government, because the elected governments prior to Narendra Modi used to give them plum postings. They were made vice chancellors of universities. They were made to hold government offices. They were given money. They were given position. Now this has all been snatched away from them. So these guys are hell-bent on writing columns, giving speeches, likes of Arundhati Roy, a Booker Prize winner. Somebody sent me the link that, oh, she is a Booker Prize winner, she is speaking and writing against these old things. There is this whole nexus of people and nexus of media houses who are constantly trying to dehumanize Hindus and pushing the agenda of violence as something, you know, self-defense or self-protection or as dissent. Imagine someone telling that we will break USA into pieces and getting away with that. In India, that is happening. There are people who chanted slogans. They are chanting Islamic slogans, Hinduon se Azadi, means we will get rid of Hindus from this land, our land. 78% Hindus in India. Muslims are gathering at a place, and these are not uneducated Muslims. No. They are very much holding PhD degrees. They are from universities. They are chanting these slogans, anti-Hindu slogans, Hinduon se Azadi. They are chanting slogans, they are writing on wall, Khilafat, Caliphate. That is in ISIS. That is ISIS trying to do the rule of Islamic Ummah. They are desecrating sacred Hindu symbols like swastik. They are writing fuck Hindutva. They are writing Hindutva ki kabar khudegi AMU ki dharti par, which means on the land of, on the campus of Aligarh Muslim University, one of the prominent minority universities of India, we will dig the grave of Hindutva. And what is Hindutva? Hindutva is being a Hindu, like Christianity for Christians. Imagine someone in Caltech or say MIT chanting slogans that we will dig out the graves of Christianity on this land. How will you react? Do you know how Hindus reacted? They did nothing. Hindus did nothing. Even when chants of, you know, our goddesses, Mata Kali, Mother Kali, she was shown in a hijab or burqa, Islamic attire. What was the need for that? Imagine doing same thing to any Islamic symbol. You remember Charlie Hebdo, the cartoonists who were murdered. You remember every single European major city that has been bombed by ISIS and Islamic militants or terrorists around, you know, the decade. Imagine the several mass shootings by Islamic militants or terrorists in USA. Think about it. That is what happens when they consider yourself as enemies. In India, Hindus are in majority, they don't do anything about it. They are so tolerant about this thing. They say, okay, somebody is saying something, it doesn't harm our dharma or religion. But it doesn't work the same other way around. A majority in India is constantly, you know, pushed towards the wall. It is a ridiculous thing to, you know, it has been propagated that how come a majority become a victim. We are. Hindus are victims in this nation where they are the sole, means a large majority. Our things, the same thing, I just told you, the brutal murders and brutalities inflicted on Hindus in these anti-Hindu riots of Delhi, these are outweighed by a slap on the face of Imran, a Muslim. A slap and intestines ripped apart. A slap, intestines ripped apart. A few Hindu men surrounding a Muslim, that outdoes Negi's burnt body without any limbs. this is how it is being projected. This is how a completely well executed, well planned anti-Hindu riots become anti-Muslim riots, because you folks tend to read only certain kind of media. You need to accept the fact that a minority can be oppressor and perpetrator of a large scale violence, and the majority can be a victim. This is what is happening in India. You are always told about Godhra 2002 riots under Narendra Modi. Do you even try to know what started that carnage? 59 Hindu holy men were burnt alive in a train coach. The four doors, six doors were bolted shut from outside, and that whole bogey was set on fire. Imagine that happening to your pastors and fathers and padres and people, Christian white folks. Imagine that they are going in a bus and somebody surrounds the bus and locks the gates and sets it on fire. That happened in Godhra, that instigated or, you know, started the riots. Nobody tells you that. Stop reading shit like The Wire, Quint, Scroll, NDTV. Shitty people who write shit like Barkha Dutt, Rana Ayu, these people who are constantly pushing propaganda, anti-Hindu and anti-India propaganda. They share fake news. They manufacture fake news. If they can't find anybody, they will show you the shot of feet of, you know, certain person, and they will tell you a very emotionally moving story. They are so much scared that they cannot come on camera and tell you what happened to them. And it turns out that guy is a part of camera crew. This is how these trusted brands of Indian media behave. Several times we have caught their lies and we have exposed them. But as they say, dog's tail, you know, even if you keep it in a pipe, take it out like 1 year, 2 year, it will just curl down. That is happening in India. That is how this whole media landscape in India is. That is how they are reporting this whole thing. Try to know the second side, the other side of the story. It is very easy to, you know, go into a Muslim locality and ask around what is happening. But it is very hard to even consider that Hindus, who are the minority in that particular area, Muslims inflicted this kind of violence because Hindus were in less number. These were Muslim dominated localities where East Delhi riots took place. So it was easy for them, the majority community there, to lynch, set on fire, hurl stones, fire guns. Automatic weapons were fired. People are giving testimony. So just don't indulge yourself in just one kind of media. Try reading the other side as well. You will find the stories and you will start to, you know what is actually happening. Don't rely on Wikipedia. I don't know what else you guys have to study about it or read about it. You will always tend to, you know, go towards that Wikipedia, and Wikipedia is so much compromised. There is nothing anti-left that survives on Wikipedia pages, especially when it comes to Indian media or India itself. So you will have to make yourself aware. And I have shared certain screenshots and images with you. Rest depends upon you, how you see it, how you, from where you go from here, you know, how you consume the whole thing I told you, or when you start to search around and look around and find the stories of people. And if I am lying, just prove me wrong. Namaskar.